What's up, everybody? It's Cringewalker here. Today we're gonna be doing I'm gonna be doing a little bit of a video tutorial for you guys, making a Kunkai Sheriff's House car. But I have in all my cars, I'm implementing my own turn signal pack, basically. So that not using the normal chassis turn signal, we're using my own that I made, which incorporates the sound control. It doesn't have to be a police car, but you will want to have this GUI in there. And let's go ahead and take a look at this. So in the actual controls, you see I have my turn signals here. I have one for these right here are for whenever you hit S. That's going to be your brake lights. L, you got your headlights. And that's it. Again, I'm basically changing out all the factory lights. And then right here is the turn signals. You got Z for left, C is right, and X is hazards. So I already incorporated with mainly my CHP vehicles, but I'm bringing it to this pack too, the wig-wags that flash. So let me just show you guys what it looks like. And I'm sorry if there's any echo. I believe this is my first video in this room. A new room, or if there's any echo or any background noise or anything. So here we go. Let's show the car off, make sure everything is, yep, it's all good. An OBS. I'm still working on scripting lights for this, but as you see, you got your normal running lights are on no matter what in this car. Let's turn the left turn signal on. See, just like the Dodge Charger, it shuts the running light off, and then it does the turn signal. So what I'm gonna, and it also does in the back. And one thing I noticed, it does charge us when they have the brakes on. Oh, that is hazards. All the turn signals are off, turn brakes on, and the dodge charges when they turn the turn signal on. They flash like that too. So I'm going to incorporate something to where the back brake lights / turn signals flash when the light bar is in full code 3. But when you hit the brakes, they go steady, just as like a brake cutout. I saw a lot of people in the TFI Discord server saying just duplicate the models, have one which is the one for the lights and one for brake lights, and then put the brake lights in front of the actual flashing ones, which I don't really like that because it's a lot of stuff. It's a lot more than you need, really. What I'm doing is, it does take a lot more, it's a little bit more scripting, but in the end it's a lot cleaner and it's just a lot cooler also, knowing that you did it. So let me just see what I got. I'm trying to remember, it's been a minute since I did these. So this is the it's called a run whale. Just when you have your lights and sirens, like, you know, whale, like the light, the siren pattern, the siren tone, the rain lights. So basically saying, if light bar value equals 3, which is full code 3, then it's gonna disable blink run, which is this, which basically says, shut off which running lights, daytime running lights, if a certain value is on. And then that, yep, yeah, okay. Alright, so we're gonna do this. It's a little bit of pain because I was not when I wrote this script, it was on the CHP cars and there's no reverse wig-wags, so let me just look real quick. Cause like I said, it's been a minute since I used to start brakes. These are all brake off, and then okay. So this is going to be left. This is left turn signal up here. And these are all if the brakes are off. So left is left turn signal up here, brakes are off. Okay. Alright, what I'm probably going to do, same thing with this. Okay, I'll just duplicate that script, rename it to break ELS. All right. Script up here, and that value equals 3. We're gonna, I just wanna see how, I'm just gonna try this first. Change it to script, which I believe is that one. Then we're gonna do script.parent dot or left dot transparency equals 0, script.parent dot right dot transparency equals 1, and we're gonna do weight 0.2, and then just copy this bottom section, little space, duplicate or paste it, and then flip the lights around. And then let's change anything down here. Let's just test it out and see what happens. For the load, I'm gonna make my output tab a little bit bigger so I can see anything. For the Ford thing. Okay, so we got, you know, brake lights work and everything. So let's just, I don't think I did it right. I mean, that's right. No. Okay. Alright. Yeah, because I tried hitting the brakes and it didn't work. So what we don't want to worry about is we don't want to worry about having the turn signals work. But, this is what we'll do. And let's add another instance to this if statement. Another statement. Instance statement, whatever. Script.parent.breaks. Yep. Break.value equals. Is it a false or is it a 1? No, it's a 0, 1. Alright. Equals 0. So that's saying if it's off. Sorry, I've not the corona, though. Luckily, I have something going on. Alright. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. And this is what we'll do. We're gonna copy it, basically duplicate this just to change it to, let's change this to else if instead of if, because we don't have an ending. If one. And one. So, okay. This is saying if it's full code 3 and brakes are on, what we're gonna do is disable false. Weight 0, and if lights are off, yeah, brake. Yeah, okay. All right, let's try it now. Hopefully this works. I don't want it to interfere either with the wig-wags, so we'll have to check that. I don't believe it will, but because those are two different scripts. Alright, we're in full code 3. Yep, flashing. Good. Turn it off. Good shit. See, the fronts are still flashing. Yep, brakes are on in the front. See. That's awesome. Turn it off. Let's see. Oh, we got our left turn signal in the front on. Nothing up. Nope. Turn it on like this. See, it's flashing. Also, it's in the front. I mean, it's not exactly like I wanted to, but I mean, it is a lot better. Let me just shut these brakes. There we go. I guess it's a lot better than what everyone else is suggesting. I don't think I'm going to, let's just, also I'm going to show off how to do a livery changer. It's super easy. It took me like 4 minutes to figure out how to do it and write a script and everything for it. But with this car, I don't know if I'm going to implement this with any other car. Oh, that's weird. Okay. I don't know if I'm going to implement this with any other car. I'm going to get in the car. I got to make everything can collide false on the light bar and shit like that. Alright, let's see. I put You can see particles. They don't look the best in the day. Or just to move them forward or something. But so that's when you hit the brakes, the actual brake lights fill up. So that's pretty cool. And I also added some extra flashing. It doesn't look the most realistic because there's only one light in the brake in the tail lights, I believe, or not. The Ford Taurus, but I don't know because I don't own one. Yeah, let's, because that was the entire idea of the video. We've only been here for 10 minutes. That's probably all I'm going to do. Let's do a little bit of scripting on these lights, though. Since, well, I don't think else to do. Alright, so we already got our scripting for the actual light bar. We're going to do the front part there. Let me just duplicate that script, since this is the same body. Just totally hit my wire on my mic. Whatever the name it. DKDN. Okay. I'm just gonna remove all of this. That's not for this car. Okay. Script that parent. Dot. I have to change the names of these side ones because I didn't. Okay. Left, I know. Alley. This is right alley. Right alley. Dot transparency equals one. Script that parent dot DK. That transparency equals one. This is also how stage lights are work. This is how stage car scripts work. I know I had someone ask me that, I believe. How to do staged. So you gotta add a strobes. Basically take your normal strobe script and then move everything out except everything up here. And then do if script up parent equals zero, then script up parent one, so on and so forth, all the way down to three. And then once you hit three, else if script up parent dot on dot value equals three, then script up parent dot on dot value equals zero. So that has a circle of well, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, basically, so on and so forth. Let's finish these lights so that they flash like I want them to. I'm probably going to not do anything with the alley lights, just so that they are, they'll actually just be alley lights, so when I, activate the takedowns, this script will shut off, the takedowns and the takedown group will go on, and then once I shut those off, these ones will come back on and flash like they're supposed to. Let me just finish this and I'll show you guys how to do the how to do the livery thing. No. That's right. Yep, that's right. Okay. One thing that's good about my videos, I don't really know how to edit, so all my videos, they just basically I record them, and once I click end, I post it on YouTube, so you guys will see everything. Okay, so this is the color. So you're gonna take the actual body, just the shell of the car with all the color on it. If you want like that glint, you don't put that in there. You want like the reflective bit, you don't put that in there. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to color, you're gonna make your color group, and then you get to name everything. Every mesh in the car, whatever you want to name it, you gotta remember some part of the script. So the same thing with staged staged lights. So you have your number value, which will be which livery you want, and then you got obvious. This is what the this is the script. So if it's on zero, then it's going to be basically, you got to do this. If main dot main var dot on dot value equals 0, then. And this is also people, I saw people asking me why their main vet wasn't working, and they didn't have this part. This is this one right here that's highlighted, main vet equals script.parent. To Roblox, if you don't have that in there in your script, main vet is nothing. Main vet is nothing to the script. It's, you gotta have it equal something. So you're gonna do is you're gonna do main vet dot body dot texture ID equals, and then in parentheses you put the it's gonna be the RBX asset ID colon back or slash slash and then the actual INS number. And it's gonna be just what you're gonna change this name here to whatever it is, whatever the mesh is named. And then in your siren control panel, let me zoom out right here, you're gonna have your own instance for the color. And that's when you press the, I said it said it's period, so when you press period, color changes in the vehicle. I'm gonna be doing it to where it's GUI, and I'll show that off when I make it. So yeah. Hope you guys, you know, learned something from the video. Enjoy, like, comment, subscribe, share it with people that are new to developing police cars. So take care, guys. Peace out.